So it is my pleasure today to speak about one of the very important hot issues in nephrology, the use of RAS inhibitors in COVID-19 era. So this is the title which stimulated me to review the axis of renin-angiotensin system. And at the end of this presentation, we'll declare the agreed guidelines about the points of whether to continue or to discontinue RAS inhibitors. And by RAS inhibitors, I mean angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors or angiotensin receptor blockers. I have nothing to declare. There is no industrial affairs in this presentation. To start with, this is the line, the timeline of renin angiotensin system. Starting from the early 80s, where the discovery of renin was there. So since 1898, many years back, century and a half. And then this is the time of discovery of angiotensin in 1939. And here angiotensin, and this is a component of angiotensin system that I'm going to explain in the next slide. So this is the timeline. And here we are living in the era of COVID, where we know now that angiotensin converting enzyme isotype 2 is the receptor for COVID-19 entry. To start with, I think this is a very important and basic point regarding the how the system is organized, renin angiotensin system. So if we go one step by one step, this is the angiotensinogen, and then by the action of renin, angiotensinogen is converted into angiotensin 1. And by angiotensin converting enzyme, which is the famous enzyme that is inhibited by angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors, then angiotensin 1 is transformed into angiotensin 2. Angiotensin 2 reacts on these two types of receptors. Angiotensin type 1 receptor, when it is these receptors are stimulated, this will lead to vasoconstriction, aldosterone secretion, sodium and water retention, inflammation, fibrosis, and regulation of immune system. And if angiotensin type 2 receptor is stimulated, this will lead to vasodilatation. So what we need in the physiology, we need proper amount of angiotensin 2 to control blood pressure, to control everything for the hemodynamics. But the problem is, when the system is activated and we have very high level of angiotensin 2. Parallel to angiotensin 2, there is this pathway, angiotensin 1 to 7 and angiotensin 1 to 9. We have cellular angiotensin converting enzyme isotype 2 that if reacts on angiotensin 1, it transforms angiotensin 1 to angiotensin 1 to 9. And it can also cleave angiotensin 2 into angiotensin 1 to 7. If angiotensin 2 leads to vasoconstriction and inflammation, angiotensin 1 to 7 and 1 to 9 are to the opposite direction. So through stimulation of mass receptor, angiotensin 1 to 7 leads to vasorelaxation, cardioprotection, antioxidant, anti-inflammatory, anti-angiotensin 2 induced signaling, antifibrotic. So if we put this balance together, we have the angiotensin 2, when it is very high level, it is bad, and we have angiotensin 1 to 7, which protects body systems against the bad effects of angiotensin 2. So for keeping physiology, we want everything to be in its volume, without any compromise to the other. This is the how COVID-19 enters the cell. It enters the cell the spike binds angiotensin converting enzyme isotype 2. And I mentioned in the previous slide that angiotensin isoenzyme 2 is protect the body against the bad effects of increased angiotensin 2. So when the virus binds this pathway, it inhibits the angiotensin 1 to 9 and the angiotensin 1 to 7, and it keeps the balance toward increased angiotensin 2. Increased angiotensin 2 binds to the type 1 receptor of angiotensin 2 that lead to acute lung injury, adverse myocardial remodeling, vasoconstriction, vascular permeability, and inflammation. By the way, the ACE inhibitors work here through inhibition of the conversion of angiotensin 1 to angiotensin 2, and ARB inhibits the angiotensin type 1 receptor. So this is the pathway. We have angiotensin 2 pathway and angiotensin 1 to 7 pathway. And we need the balance between the two systems. And there is an important signal of safety. What is the signal of safety? There is some observation that hypertension is a risk factor for COVID-19 severe illness. And from experimental animal models, they found that the use of ACE inhibitors or angiotensin receptor blockers increase angiotensin converting enzyme isotype 2. And we know that the virus binds this coenzyme receptor. So if this coenzyme receptor is increased, then viral illness will be more severe. This is the idea. But this idea is based on experimental animal models, and it wasn't proven in human studies up to this moment. Let us go back to the angiotensin converting enzyme isotype 2, because I like it very much. Angiotensin converting enzyme isotype 2, which is protective against angiotensin 2, is expressed all over the body, in the CNS, in the upper airway, in the vasculature, lungs, and this is the problem when the angiotensin converting enzyme type 2 expression is increased in the pneumocytes. This will facilitate COVID-19 because this is a binding receptor for the virus. In liver, gut, kidneys, glomerular endothelial cells, podocyte, proximal tubular endothelial cells, and by the presence of this angiotensin converting enzyme expression in these structures, it protects them against inflammation and fibrosis. In the heart, because we have Dr. Hoda with us today from cardiology side, the isoenzyme 2 is protective for the heart. So it works on, it is expressed in these structures, cardiofibroblasts, cardiomyocytes, endothelial cells, pericytes, epicardial adipose cells, and even in the eyes. So again, angiotensin converting enzyme type 2 is very nice pathway, protects the body system from the highly expressed angiotensin 2 and protects against inflammation and fibrosis. And this is a very interesting figure. If the angiotensin converting enzyme isoenzyme 2 is reduced in the intestine by the virus, what will happen? There is gut dysbiosis. What's meant by gut dysbiosis? A disturbance of gut microbiome. And this will lead to increased inflammation, increased permeability, and the dysbiosis will lead to cascade of inflammation, and the bacteria will find its way to the blood with subsequent damaging effect on the cardiopulmonary status and other body systems. So again, it is not only the cardiovascular system, it is not only hypertension, but as well many structures like gut and the gut microbiome. And this figure links angiotensin converting enzyme type 2 with gut dysbiosis and cardiovascular disease. In diabetic cardiovascular complication, there are multitude of mechanisms. The environment after virus and COVID-19 binds to the angiotensin isotype 2 is the environment. The environment is reduction of the angiotensin converting enzyme isotype 2, And in the, this is the antagonistic of angiotensin 2. If the antagonistic is inhibited, this will increase angiotensin 2. So angiotensin 2 is stimulated, increased. Why increased? Because the isoenzyme 2 cleaves angiotensin 2. If it is not cleaved, it will be elevated. And angiotensin 127, which is the product of angiotensin converting enzyme isotype 2, is reduced. So there is imbalance. This is unphysiological balance. So we have increased angiotensin 2, which is bad, and the reduction of angiotensin 127, which is we need it. This means that all body systems will suffer from this imbalance. If you take it step by organ, starting by the heart, increase reactive oxygen species, hypertrophy, inflammations, a lot of problems with the vascular system, adipocytes, liver, kidney, hypertrophy and inflammation, skeletal muscle, lung, which is the organ of severe COVID, by increasing inflammation, vascular remodeling, endothelial dysfunction, and the cardiopulmonary dysfunction. Even brain, pancreas, and bone marrow. So the imbalance of angiotensin 2 to 127 is really driving bad consequences. This is one of the very important articles in the cardiology. In heart failure, patients with heart failure. So this study is restricted only to the heart failure patients. In heart failure patients, they evaluated circulating plasma level of angiotensin converting enzyme type 2 in men and women. And I put in the title here impact of gender, because in this study, where the authors evaluated angiotensin converting enzyme type 2 concentration in 1,485 men and 537 women with heart failure, what they found? They found that the use of ACE inhibitors or ARBs are not associated with no problems, no increase of angiotensin converting enzyme as a type 2. It is only the gender here, which is very significant. So men have very high level of angiotensin converting enzyme isotype 2 with the after infection with COVID. And ACE inhibitors or ARBs don't increase the level anymore. So the problem here in the gender, males are more prone to the problems, and this is one of the risk factors in the severity of COVID with heart failure. And this, the editorial comments on this article referred to the effects of ADAMS-17. What is ADAMS-17? If we look at, again, I'm repeating the informations. If this is angiotensin 1, and by converting enzyme, this angiotensin 1 is moved to angiotensin 2, and this is angiotensin 2. The effect of isoenzyme type 2 is to change 1 to 9 and 2 to 7. Here the virus binds to the spike of the virus, binds to the isoenzyme type 2 to find its way to the cell. What happened when the virus binds to the angiotensin converting enzyme isotype 2? It stimulates here another driving factor, which is ADAM-17. ADAM-17 is a cleavage for angiotensin converting enzyme isotype 2. This is the structure of isoenzyme type 2. There is cellular, extracellular, and cellular domain. And here, ADAM-17 cleaves this part. So this part is cleaved from angiotensin converting enzyme 2. And it becomes inactive. When isoenzyme 2 is inactive, this will lead the game for angiotensin 2 to drive all the bad effects of angiotensin 2. And here, if we use ACE inhibitors or ARBs, it will inhibit the bad effect of angiotensin 2. So this is the theory in heart failure. In heart failure, the problem is in the ADAM-17 pathway. And it is well known that Adam 17 is more active in men than women. And virus stimulates Adam 17. And Adam 17 disrupts isoenzyme type 2 effects. So this is the imbalance that occurs. And every minute, I'm adding to the structure and the composition of RAS system some points. I think this is one of the most important points to be bottom mind. And this is the one of very interesting articles in the viruses journal. It is here they evaluated Adam 17 and another pathway, which is this pathway, type 2 transmembrane serine protease, which is TMB-RSS2 pathway. In this article, and I recommend all of you to read this article, they both the hypothesis that we have two cleavages for cellular angiotensin converting enzyme as type 2 by Adam 17 and by TMB RSS2. Here in this article, they discussed that Adam 17 cleavage is beneficial, not harmful, as I mentioned in the last slide. But the most harmful is cleavage of the tissue of cellular angiotensin converting enzyme as type 2 by TMB-RSS2. Because this cleavage led to all the consequences of accelerated lung infection, inflammation, cytokine storm, and all these problems that you find in the slide. So again, we have renin, angiotensin, and the angiotensin system. We have angiotensin 1 and angiotensin 2. And angiotensin 2 stimulates the inflammation fibrosis, ATC. And we have the counter current system, which is modulated by the enzyme type 2, depending upon the angiotensin 1 to 7 and 1 to 9. This is the situation. Look here. If we don't use ACE inhibitor or ARBs, virus binds to the isoenzyme type 2 and then internalized and takes the receptor inside the cell. And here, angiotensin 2 become acting on the angiotensin type 1 receptor without the counter current system. What will happen? We don't have the beneficial effects of angiotensin converting enzyme isotype 2. And we have exceeded function of angiotensin 2. This will lead to exceeding inflammation and fibrosis. If we use ACE inhibitors or ARBs, the ACE inhibitor or ARBs exert their anti-inflammatory effect. So this is to the contrary of what we believe. Use of ACE and ARB, according to this hypothesis, may be beneficial even for respiratory system, reduce inflammation within the lung, because it opposes the use of ACE inhibitor or ARBs opposes the bad effects of angiotensin type 2. Okay. This is from experimental animal model using resveratrol, which is antioxidant, increase even angiotensin converting enzyme type 2, and it is beneficial in this experimental animal model. And what about telmisartan? Telmisartan is angiotensin receptor blocker. And this is a commentary. Why they discuss telmisartan? Because telmisartan is angiotensin receptor blocker with the longest plasma half-life, 24 hours. It has high tissue concentration due to high lipid solubility and high volume distribution and dissociates more slowly after binding to angiotensin type 1 receptor. So this is all these actions. They put in mind to use telmisartan as protective. And is there any studies for that? This is the randomized control trial, open label, that just started. Enrollment of the patient in the hospital, in Argentina, 80 milligram twice daily after the diagnosis of COVID-19, 80 milligram telmisartan twice daily, oral, after the test is detected to be positive, versus standard of care, and we are waiting the result of this study. So to sum up this part of the presentation, we now know that the virus finds its way through the RAS system, through angiotensin converting enzyme as type 2. And there was a dogma and a fear that the use of ACE inhibitors or ARBs that stimulates angiotensin converting enzyme type 2 may increase viral infection. And as I mentioned, it is an experimental animal, not proved in human. And to the extreme, this is a randomized controlled trial to test the use of ARB for patients with COVID-19. And this is another very interesting study. Here, the virus, when binds to the receptor, this is the receptor of the virus. If the virus binds to the receptor, it finds its way to the cell. How if we inject and treat the patient by soluble angiotensinogen converting enzyme isotype 2? So this is, if we treat the patient with this soluble form of the isoenzymes type 2, it will bind the virus. By binding the virus here in the blood, the virus will not find its way to the inside the cells, and this may be protective. So we are waiting further studies how to handle RAS system in a good and friendly way. Is there any human data about the RAS inhibitors and COVID-19? I'm starting with this study. This is an old study, old data. They collected the data of influenza because they found influenza also uses angiotensin converting enzyme type 2. It simulates COVID-19. The advantage of this data is 5.6 million persons in the United Kingdom from clinical practice research data link with a median follow-up 8.7 years. So a huge number of patients. And then this is the key results. What are the results? If you look here, this is the incidence of influenza according to the use of ACE inhibitors. And look here at the number of patients. This is the ACE inhibitor users, more than 700,000, and more than 4.7 million no ACE inhibitors. What do you see? Using of ACE inhibitors is associated even with reduction of the incidence of influenza. What about angiotensin receptor blocker use? The same. And this is the number of patients treated with ARB. More than 230,000 patients. So this is a big, huge number of patients in the influenza era. And after 8 years of follow-up, the use of ACE inhibitors or angiotensin receptor blockers were protective against the influenza. Although influenza virus finds its way to the cell through the same pathway of COVID-19. And here, either using ACE inhibitor or angiotensin receptor blockers, the longer the duration of taking these medications, the lower the risk of influenza. So this is from influenza literature, the use of RAS blockade or RAS inhibitors are beneficial. What about COVID-19? What are the data of RAS inhibitors in COVID-19 era? This is one of important studies. It is assessed 8,910 patients with COVID-19. 500 patients died in the hospital, and the death rate is 5.8%, and 8,300 survived. And the aim of this study is to assess predictors of in-hospital death. Do the use of ACE inhibitors or ARBs increase mortality? Let us to look at the results. Where is the ACE inhibitor and the ARBs? This is the ACE inhibitors and the ARBs. What happens? They are protecting. The odds of mortality is less than one, significantly less than one. So the use of ACE inhibitors or ARBs in this cohort of patients was even protective and was not associated with increased risk of in-hospital death. So, and here the old age, if the age of above 65, there is increased odds ratio of mortality, coronary heart disease, congestive heart failure, arrhythmias, COPD, current smokers, all these are predictors of increased cardiovascular death. But here, female sex, it seems it is protective, as I mentioned in the introductory segment of the presentation. And here, of no doubt, the use of ACE inhibitors or ARBs are associated with reduced mortality. Another study, this is JAMA article, JAMA Cardiology, and the question, among patients with hypertension, do those taking angiotensin-converting enzyme inhibitors or angiotensin receptor blockers have greater illness severity or increased risk of mortality during hospitalization for coronavirus disease? So this is a direct, again, the finding in this study, in this single center case series involving 362 patients with hypertension hospitalized with COVID-19 infection, there was no difference in severity of the disease, complications, and the risk of death in those who were taking ACE inhibitor or ARBs compared with those not treated with these medications, assuring study. Another study, although it included a small number of patients, 42 patients, 17 patients only treated with ACE inhibitor or ARBs, but I find it interesting. Why? Because even in this study, they found the red color means moderate disease, and severe, the yellow color reflects severe disease. So patients who are not treated with ACE or ARBs, here the majority of the fraction of severe disease is significantly higher than those treated with ACE or ARBs. And they proved here that the use of ACE or ARBs are associated with reduction of interleukin 6, and this is one of the cytokines that refers to inflammation. So in this study, although it includes small number of patients, it documents superiority of the RAS inhibitors. This is another study from the United States, the use of renin angiotensin aldosterone system inhibitors and the risk of COVID-19. And this study included larger number of patients. And this is, again, this is the number of patients treated with ACE inhibitors, here with ARBs, ACE inhibitor or ARBs, beta blocker, calcium channel blocker, SSRI diuretics. And then in this part of the slide, the matched patients with hypertension, COVID-19 patients treated with medication, and COVID-19 patients in not treated with medication. So we have here two groups. This is a group of patients who are not treated with this antihypertensive treatment, and this is the cohort of patients treated with antihypertensive treatment. Again, here, if we look at ACE inhibitors, here, 61%, no difference, almost no difference. And the same for ARBs. So again, this cohort of patients confirms that the use of ACE or ARBs is not associated with increased COVID-19. What about COVID severity of the disease? If you look at severe diseases and the use of ACE or ARBs, here, 23% in ACE inhibitor treated of the patients has severe disease, here 27%. This means that even severe disease is less with ACE inhibitors, comparable in ARBs. Again, even if we take COVID-19 at large or severe COVID-19 disease, there is no effect of ACE or ARBs to increase the disease. Another article from Italy about the same issue. Again, if you look at the adjusted hazard risk here for COVID-19, odds ratio for COVID-19, ACE inhibitor is 0.9, less than 1, ARBs 0.9, calcium channel blocker 1.03, insignificant as well. Beta blocker is insignificant. So again, all antihypertensive treatments if we take them one by one, they have no relation to the COVID-19. Yes, all these studies are observational studies, not interventional studies. And I think there are few randomized controlled trials trying to use RAS inhibitors for treatment of COVID-19. And we are waiting their results in the future. What about guidelines to close this presentation? All societies, hypertension, cardiovascular, cardiology, have their statements to not to discontinue. So the advice against the discontinuation of RAS blockade. And only we discontinue RAS inhibitors if there is general contraindications like shock state, etc. And this is the National Institute Health guidelines and recommendations. Regarding angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors and angiotensin receptor blockers, if the patient is treated with any of them, persons with COVID-19 who are prescribed the ACE inhibitor or ARBs for cardiovascular disease or other indication should continue these medications. And the COVID-19 treatment guidelines panel recommend against the use of ACE inhibitors or ARBs for treatment of COVID-19. This is the use of RAS inhibitors to treat COVID-19. Still, we need further evidence. So according to the evidence I presented today, there is no harm of continuation of ACE inhibitor or ARBs in treating COVID-19. And there is human data suggesting the use of RAS inhibitors may be protective. But up to this moment of time, we are not sure if we can advise for the use of RAS inhibitors as a treatment for COVID-19. So we are waiting the effects of the publications and randomized control trial. So in one statement, we don't have evidence of harm of ACE inhibitor or ARBs. So please continue ACE inhibitor or ARBs when you treat your patients, especially those who have cardiovascular risk, because if you stop them, this will make harm by increasing cardiovascular complications and the problem. And I think this is the end of my presentation, and I'd like to stop here. And if you have any questions or comments, I like to hear from you. Dr. Muhammad Al-Hadid, do you have any questions?
I think the lecture was crystal clear, and I don't have a question. It was a great lecture. Thank you so much, Dr. Hussein.
Dr. Tariq.
لا هايله بصراحه وابديتد واحنا بصراحه يعني احنا ما بنشوفش حالات كتير او ما شفناش حالات كوفيد 19 لكن بقى عندنا دلوقتي وعي كافي ان موضوع الايس واي ار بيز بقت خلاص قصه محسومه ان احنا ما نوقفش الادويه دي تمام اكسلنت يا باشا
ذا بوينت هير اي كلاريفايد بيوند ذا ايس اند اربز ذا يوز اوف ايس اند ارب ان كوفيد 19 اي ثينك اي هايلايتد the renin-angiotensin pathway. And I shed the light on angiotensin converting enzyme ALF5 2 because I think there are many, many trials, even in the experimental work, to use angiotensin converting enzyme 2 for treating diabetic nephropathy and other diseases. Dr. Mu'tasim. Dr. Mu'tasim. If Dr. Huda, if Dr. Huda wants to comment. Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
And goodbye.
And goodbye.
Shukran.